Hello again, it's me, obviously, and today we are trying to fix, I'm not even sure what this is, some kind of main power distribution box from Peugeot or Citroën, made of Siemens video, and the problem is that output, it is fuse number 5 and it should be a fuel pump fuse, but fuel pump is not running with this unit, and the spare units are very rare, and so let's try to pop that open and see what is wrong with it. Looks really bad. The whole unit is potted on that gunk. So repairing this could be really pain in the butt. Sounds really hollow, so maybe that potting material is only on a top of PC board. So if there somewhere are screws, we can take them off and hopefully whole package will pop out, but I'm not sure. Can I film that thing? Because I think it is going to take for a while. Another option is put the hole in here and then glue it back together. But I don't like it. Yeah, I will little bit dig around and I will get you back soon. we are in, but there is nothing interesting for us, so this cutoff is totally not worth it. But maybe I can use now this hole to try to pull out the whole PC board. And then I have to try to rip off that gunk. So my guess is that there is a relay, maybe that one, because it is close to fuse, and I think the relay is bad, but the relay legs didn't come through the port what I am expecting. So the relays are surface mounted and in that gunk. We made it, little bit brutal way, but it is really obvious that that constructor do not want us to be there. So annoying. But now it's look like a sandwich, bottom PCB, upper PCB, and all the relays, what I'm suspecting is through hole components, the legs are in there, but we need to desolder these, maybe these, yes, these, at these to get access of them. So let's try it. A little bit cleaning like that. there is the PC port number one. There are all the low power stuff, and it seems to be that PCB, so the top PCB, which has all relays and fuses. And there is that fuel pump fuse, so we can see now there is the fuse and the trace goes there. So bottom left corner, yes, it is there, but so sadly we can't trace down that where the power line of the fuse is going. We need to do some ticking thing in there to see where it goes. Or then just try to guess. Okay, well, there is the fuse leg, and surprisingly, the power on that fuse comes right over there. The fucking outer and the farthest relay, there, what I can imagine. Why the fuck it's going so far away? And and if it is that relay there, what is our problem? Fuel pump relay. And when we flip the port over, there is a really suspicious looking leg. That what I can tell is this leg has been really hot, because the potting material is gone through there and so on. Yes. I have done a little bit offline work. So there is that top PCB port, and in this hole supposed to be that one relay. What now on I have been taking off, and there was that bad joint, shitty connection. And it appears to be, I'm not sure, can I show you, but I'll try. Little bit hard to do with the hand, but the battery power goes there, that crappy little joint, and inside the relay the battery power is jumped over these terminals, which again passes the power out on there. What are, I suppose, yes, few main fuses there. So the fuel pump is there, these terminals, and positive terminal is there, where the power comes on the relay, there is a bad contact, and if relay do not engage the power in here, you cannot have power in those main fuses or the fuel pump. So really confusing. I will try to somehow mix it the video that it makes a little bit more sense. But there are these three terminals, there, and the power comes in there, and that was the bad connection. And we are now going to energize that relay and see, do the contact work anymore, or do we have to somehow fix it a little bit? I don't know, but let's test it, then we know. There is a relay, there is a multimeter, then we can just put the wires in there, and the main terminal is there. And if the relay do contact, then the meter should show 0 ohms. It do not, it just beeps. So the problem, first of all, is bad contact. Yeah, bad contact on the relay, and that's why the relay has been started to get really hot. And there you can see little bit melting happening there, because the plastic has started to melt and the connection port is being so hot that it is desoldered itself. But I think we can fix it. It is only mechanical relay. So we can take it apart and see what is inside of it. Or obviously we already see what is inside. But yeah, you got it. We simply want to see more. There is our contact. Little bit worn out. We can scratch it good again. Yeah, but that part inside there has been melted on the plastic and kinda gone so far on that backside, so that poor connection part there can't reach it anymore. We have few options, and I think the best of them is take a knife and take that plastic edge little bit lower, so the connecting arm can touch better that connecting point.
Yeah, let's try it first, because in my opinion, if this will do the trick, it shall be pretty solid, easy fix, pretty portable, to get access on the relay button. If you fix it, just use a plastic, it's not enough. Do it fine. And clean the connector back, just like that, and cut off, it needs to be cleaned. Yeah, that's right, maybe it works.
Maybe it works. Relays and contactors are really awesome electromechanical devices, because you can actually fix and repair them almost no effort at all. Yeah. Now you can see a little bit bending. I will start closing the cap. There we have a touchdown. Touching. And when I press more, the contactor will bend a little bit. So it acts like a spring load. The contact. Let's try again. No. Why?
We are screwed.
Why it?
It is not working. What do we have? Let's see if I can find this. I don't know what is it. I don't know what it is. It should work. It must.
Contacting arm will hit on the melted plastic in there. So we need to deal that.
Hard to do that. Plastic is pretty strong. Yeah, it is already like that, but not good enough. Not good enough. And it was light, good. So we need to make a little bit more tweaking there. Just get it perfect. Because I'm not going to do that again. It's again so painful. First of all, get those and raise it apart. So I don't want to do that. So you have a
similar unit, which is broken. So I can show you the spot where the fault part there is, so you can try to do only the soldering and maybe it will fix the relay. And if not, then you have to try follow the tear down steps. I think it is possible to use a reasonable amount of force to get the canister ripped off, meanwhile the main components are still attached on the board. Then you are able to fix the crappy connector on there, and if you drill the hole on the casing, how it was that way. Yes, if you drill the hole on there, you can get access. No, not there. If you drill there, only part what you can get access is that lower PC board, that one. And I'm really sure that you are not going to want to find that PC board. So if that soldering joint, what is bad, is repaired without taking that off, then I will strongly recommend that it is really hard, but I'm not sure is it doable or not when everything is back. It could be hard, but I think it is doable. You just need, yeah, pay attention where to drill. I think that spot there is perfect drilling point. If you make a hole in that part on the plastic, then you will gain the access from the left side of that PC port, and then you have a direct access on the crappy joint on there. Then you don't have to take the whole thing apart, just like I did. Hopefully it makes sense somebody who wants to make the same repair. We can come back on that whole positioning case when I have been putted all the parts back together, so I can show you the better and the accurate spot for the grilling job. But now, because we are like a pros, we will use fast drying insulator lock, because we don't want that our fix get bad first. Let's put little bit insulation there. So when it dries, it makes that insulating shield that the moisture can't get in our solders. Okay. Yeah, it is now about to solder it. Every pin. And now we could do the test before the putting it back together, but because it is not mine and the car where this thing belongs is not here, so I will put it totally back together and cross my fingers that everything works. It wasn't really that funny what I thought it to be. Yeah, but that there we can make a little bit that snap on quick glue thing and then the two component epoxy glue to prevent the water coming in and the super glue will hold that part in its spot. Before the two component glue